Got my hands on one of the brand new iPhone SE phones. I've done 18 bin tests on high-end smartphones over the past year, which means I've probably bent more phones than anyone else in the world. I'm pretty sure my mother is extremely proud. Let's get started with the scratch test. I have a set of picks that tell me how hard or scratch-resistant the front glass is. A level 1 would be the equivalent of talc powder, and a level 10 is diamonds. This screen starts to scratch at a level 6 and has a deeper groove with a level 7 pick, which is exactly what the Galaxy S7 scored as well. Now for the back camera glass. Some smartphones use a plastic lens for their camera, like the BlackBerry Priv, which optically doesn't matter much, but durability-wise, on a heavily abused smartphone, glass is a little less prone to scratching, so I personally like when manufacturers use real glass. Luckily, Apple did use glass for this phone. Let's give them a thumbs up for using the glass to cover their 4K camera. The lens does sit perfectly flush with the back panel though. There is no protective lip like with other iPhones, so impacts can directly affect the glass. Watch out for that. The back metal is aluminum. Apple didn't brag about their 7000 series aluminum this time around, so it's possible they did drop back to the 6000 series for the more budget device. Keys and coins can scuff up the bead blasted satin finish. The Apple logo in the center of the phone is made of stainless steel. Another positive point for the iPhone SE is the home button. It appears to be made out of glass or ceramic and does not easily scratch like the plastic home button on the Galaxy S7 or the Note 5. Onto the burn test. This is always interesting to me. Every screen is made a bit different. Apple uses an IPS backlit display, which isn't quite as vibrant or saturated as an AMOLED screen. I feel like the IPS is a bit more true to life though. With time, pixels turn off from the extreme heat and then come back on again after the heat is removed, unlike the Galaxy S7 AMOLED display, which turned white and never recovered. Onto the bin test. Remember, I do these tests for every new phone that comes out, so hit that subscribe button so you're always up to date. When I apply force to the iPhone SE, it flexes a bit and then cracks right along that bottom volume button. Always a weak spot on phones. It stops flexing after the crack though, and nothing is permanently damaged. It survived more force than the Nexus 6P did, as well as the Xperia Z5, so it's a tough call, but I think this phone passes the bin test even with the minor edge damage. What do you think? Let me know in the poll in the upper corner. Thanks a ton for watching and supporting my destructive habits. Let me know in the comments what phone you would like to see tested next, and click this card if you want to see the rest of my smartphone durability tests. Check my Instagram and Twitter for behind-the-scenes pictures and a secret LEGO Star Wars project I am working on. Thanks for watching.